Hello, my name is Yoshino Tamai. Today I would like to start with this question. What is the big political event start from the next week?
October 18th.
I guess because I come from China, it's the 19th National like Party Congress in China.
Yes, exactly. Yeah, this is what I wanted to talk today. Today my topic would be the 19th Party Congress, and I want to focus how to measure Xi Jinping's political power from the result of the Congress. So first, I would like to start with a brief introduction about Party Congress, what it is. It is held every 5 years, and it will last about a week. And there are two objectives of the Congress. First is to elect the member of the party, especially the central committee. And second is to decide important policy plans for coming 5 years. Now I would like to move on to my main topic, how to measure Xi Jinping's political power from the result of the Congress. I think in 2012, when Xi Jinping was elected as the top of the party, she was not regarded as a strong leader. But during this 5 years, Xi Jinping has increased his political power through anti-corruption campaign. And this year's Party Congress is the best opportunity to measure his political power. But how to measure it? I think there are three major points to pay attention to. The first point is to whether the party constitution will be revised to include Xi Jinping's thought or not. If so, it can be said that Xi Jinping's political status in the party is as same as that of Mao Zedong or Deng Xiaoping. And the second point is whether the party will eliminate the rule of retirement age. It is said that there are unwritten rules about retirement age in the party. It's like the people 67 years old or younger can stay in the party, but people of 68 years or older have to retire from the party. And it is said that it is expected that this rule can be eliminated or abolished in this party congress. So it means that Xi Jinping can stay in power even after his second term, which is 2022. And some say that it is possible that Xi Jinping will continue his third term after finishing his second term. And considering that the former leaders, most of the former leaders retired after finishing their second term, if Xi Jinping continue his third term, it can be said that Xi Jinping grips more power than the former leaders. The last point is whether people close to Xi Jinping can join the member of standing committee. Standing committee is the most senior decision making body in China, and there are seven people in standing committee, and it is expected that four or five people out of seven will retire. So it means that four or five people would join the standing committee at this point. So many analysts expect that newly elected member will have some connection with Xi Jinping. And so if so, it can be said that she has a strong political power compared to other political factions. So in summary, to measure Xi Jinping's political power from the result of the Congress, there are three main points. First is whether the political party constitution will be revised to include Xi Jinping III. Second is to whether the internal rule about retirement age will be changed or not. And the last one is whether people close to Xi would join the standing committee. And we will see the result by the end of this October. So I'm looking forward to see the result. Mm-hmm. Thank you for your attention.
As far as I know, China has one part policy. So you mentioned other factions, it's sometimes it just thing to me. So what are other factions within that one party, part in China?
Yes, yes. I think there are some factions, mainly related to people. There are some factions, first is factions which have strong connection with Jiang Zemin, or factions with strong connection with the Yang Communist Party. And now it is said that Xi Jinping is making his own faction through during his five terms. But it is not so obvious things. Yeah.
So since you are the expert on the case, we would like to hear what will be the outcomes.
Yeah, that's the most difficult question. Yes. Yeah, I have some. I have to anticipate the result of the But I think I will see the Xi Jinping's has some strong powers. Will get strong power. Compared to other former leaders. And I think Xi Jinping's thought will be included in the constitution. And also I anticipate that in the standing committee, there will be some members that that have strong connection with Xi. Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.